One thing that happened during the breakup, as I went to my aunt's house for some guidance, because she's spiritual minister, and I had like pretty big releases there unknowingly, emotional releases there, because she asked me a question that really stuck with me. And it was like, I told her, I don't feel like I'm good enough. I just don't think I'm good enough. I don't think I'm good enough as a man, as a human, to have what I want. And she just asked me, how do you know? How do you know you're not good enough? And that kind of stuck for a moment. And I stopped and I was like, because it feels that way in my body.
Wow.
And then as I said that, I was like, it feels that way in my body. And then suddenly I just had like an emotional release in that moment. I started crying. I had this realization. I'm like, wait, I'm not my feelings. And then it started to kind of connect with me that maybe I had this all wrong. Maybe I'm buying into my own bullshit too much, and I'm not actually challenging my belief system, my paradigm, my reality. And that's when I pretty much put my life on hold at that point. After I broke up with her, I had a job offer to become a VP of sales at a tech startup
Damn.
in LA. It was going to pay me $400,000 a year, and I decided to go travel the world instead, and actually go out and do some soul searching, do some work on myself. That's where I started doing a lot of this work. I started I approached probably, I don't know, I want to say like a few thousand women in the last
Good
two and a
God.
half years, and really allowed myself to learn how to feel my body, learn how to get grounded, learn how to express my feelings, learn how to connect with feeling, learn how to drop my bullshit. And yeah, that was probably the breaking point where that question she asked me kind of broke me open. And I was like, I need to do it differently.